bitch. Make them hoes mad. Show me how you fuck her baby dad.
I'm an alien. This a taser. Yeah, I'm shit. Yeah, whole lot of shit.
Didn't really fuck with me way back then, but how about now? Cause I'm up right now, and you simply suck right now.
And I'm a lady killer, I want her, I'm a stellar. I promise I can make her fly away like caterpillar. So if you don't
think you're a monster, prove them right.
Always remember, you will never be criticized by someone who is doing more than you. You will only be criticized by someone doing less.
Please welcome Baker Matt.
One thing, no. Bitches, they come, they go. Saturday through Sunday, Monday. Monday through Sunday, yo.
Imagine the day they see you again. And you are just, well, better.
But you did a good job at really fucking up my day. And then you said you made steak. Nigga, that was banquet, Salisbury steak. You done fed me a TV dinner?
Shine me when I'm alone, and so I tell myself that I. know that you're drunk.
Yeah.
Tell me what you want out of this club.
You know you're nasty,
know you're nasty.
No. Uber out of my house, you caught a taxi.
I'm picky with my women, I'm inside. I know that you're drunk.
Yeah.
Tell me what you want out of this club.
You know you're nasty,
know you're nasty.
No.
Bring you in warm, or I can bring you in cold. I can bring you in warm, or I can bring you in cold.
Started out at a skinny 40 kilograms. He really wanted to gain some mass, so let's see the transformation. After putting in the work, here he is at an impressive 75 kilograms. And here he is after a slight cut from bulking, weighing 69 kilograms. With the added weight and muscle, he looks like a completely different person. I would totally give him a fist bump.
Cause we know
you ain't got no will.
What?
You ain't got no bottle.
Say what you tell.
Let's just be honest.
Say what you tell.
Let's just be
real. Say one time.
You ain't got no cash.
Hey.
You ain't got no dollar.
Hey.
Stay with that drama.
Sit on.
Let's just be real.
Nah.
This guy got tired of the way he looked, so he did something about it. He started bulking, working out, and taking some progress videos along the way. He's claiming he went from skinny to building muscle in just 2 years. If this is actually true and he did it all natural, then this is just really amazing and inspiring. This is one of the most aesthetic mustache transformation I've seen.
Just you date him?
No, he's fat.
And that, that hurt, you know? And I think that just, that flicked the switch in me where I was like, okay, fuck you, watch this.
Once you start, there's no going back.
I know.
This means total commitment. Once you begin the path, there is no leaving the path. Are you sure you're ready for that?
You got a heart, but fuck it, I'm saying. They need a body to finish out the cage.
I'm
so excited.
The
minimum wage, they're trying to
get
up to the
top of their face.
Is this the power of a god? Son, you know, once you start, there's no going back.
I know.
This means total commitment. Once you begin the path, there is no leaving the path. Are you sure you're ready for that?
You don't have time to step back. You got to go forward. You got to push harder. Excuses, get out of my way. That's what this is about. So you got to recognize when it gets tough, you better get tough. Easy does not count. Easy does not work. You can't cheat your way up. You got to push your way up. Not everyone is ready.
Penuhi song ini dengan perubahan badan kalian.
Extremely overweight and was constantly made fun of. But one day, Anthony had enough. He set a goal to get into shape no matter what it takes. He started going to the gym consistently despite weighing 600 pounds. And even though he thought about quitting many times, he didn't make any excuses and never gave up. Slowly but surely, he started seeing results. And after losing over 300 pounds, this is what he looks like now. Hard work really paid off for him.
You murdered me, you bitch.
Oh, get over it. You pissed me off.
Selama 3 bulan ini aku bisa nurunin berat badan dari 84 ke 74 kg dan body fat dari sekitar 27% ke 17%. Yang paling aku perhatiin adalah makanan. Aku makan sekali sehari dengan porsi high protein dan cheat day seminggu sekali biar nggak stres. Nah, untuk olahraga sendiri aku ke gym 3-4 kali seminggu dan kardio seminggu sekali. Tapi aku masih penasaran, gimana sih rasanya punya badan dengan body fat di bawah 10%? Bisa nggak ya?
Yeah.
E-R-G, the other E, and can no other lady put it down like me. I'm Fergalicious,
so delicious.
My body stays vicious. I be up in the gym just working on my fitness. He's my witness. I put your boy on rock rock and he be lining down the block just to watch what I got. So delicious.
I was in desperate need for a glow up, so come with me for a week of all my favorite treatments. Starting off with a hair gloss, I love this treatment for eliminating any brassy tones, and then went straight into nails. I decided to do French tip, and I'm obsessed. We then got laser hair removal. This is my favorite hair removal method. And then Olive and June popped by my house for a quick pedicure sesh and decided to go with this beautiful magenta. I then realized I lacked volume and I needed a haircut. I'm such a baby when it comes to trims. I'm scared they're gonna cut all my hair off. Please tell me I'm not the only one who's like that. The end result looked amazing. And then I like to get a facial once a month. And my skin has been feeling really dry lately, so I got a hydrating facial. Love the results. And we are done. Glow up is complete. I'm feeling like myself again.
So here's exactly what I did to get from this to this body. Girl, you gotta eat, but eat healthy and as clean as possible. Also, protein is key because it makes you more satisfied for a longer period of time. I work out every day without exceptions, but it doesn't mean that I go hard every single day. I do sometimes Pilates, sometimes boxing, sometimes cycling, and just walking around the city, but physical activity every single day. You gotta go to sleep early because if you stay up late, you're gonna get hungry and then you're gonna eat crappy food because that's what you usually crave during the night. I snack on fiber-rich foods, which means whenever I get hungry in between meals, I eat carrots with hummus or a bowl of vegetables like a salad or fruits, and that helps you so much to stay satisfied.
Y'all, I have to show you my insane transformation in how I took my belly from this to this. I'm a mom of two, and so during both of my pregnancies, I gained a significant amount of weight, and I got a lot of loose skin and a lot of stretch marks, and diet and exercise did not cut it. But let me show you what did. Maylee's B-Flat. B-Flat is a belly firming cream, and it reduces the appearance of stretch marks and just gives you a smoother, tighter belly. It's been clinically proven, which is amazing. And one of the best things about it is you see results after only 4 weeks, and they have a 60-day money-back guarantee. Y'all have to give it a try.
I start every birthday with a run. It's a tradition I dedicate to my former self.
To celebrate getting out of obesity and all the hard work I've done to have this kind of energy. I've learned a lot on my journey, but mostly...
Every positive effort is a love letter.
We are all made up of so many chapters, so many memories etched into our bodies. You can change, you can stay the same, but you are sort of shoot across the sky. Even if your life feels dim sometimes, you never know who you could guide. You're yourself.
Extraordinary change belongs to us all, and I celebrated that by sprinting up some stairs the morning of my 30th birthday that I would have struggled to walk up only a few years ago.
Si tu débutes ta musculation, voici un programme de 3 séances par semaine qui va te permettre de prendre de la masse. Mais avant ça, enregistre le post et abonne-toi pour plus de conseils. Commence le lundi avec une séance haut du corps comprenant 2 exercices de développé pour les pecs, 2 exercices de tirage pour le dos, 1 exercice de développé pour les épaules, 1 exercice pour les biceps et triceps en superset et pour finir, un circuit pour les abdos. Le mercredi, tu vas faire une séance bas du corps avec 1 exercice de presse ou squat, 1 exercice de fente, 1 exercice de flexion de hanche, 2 exercices d'extension et de flexion de genoux avec du leg extension et du leg curl en superset et pour pour finir du gainage pour les abdos. Et le vendredi, on repart sur une séance haut du corps avec deux exercices de développé pour les pecs et les épaules, deux mouvements de tirage horizontal et vertical, et tu vas finir avec de l'isolation sur les biceps, triceps et les épaules en mettant le focus sur tes points faibles. Si tu veux te transformer physiquement et que tu veux être encadré pour y arriver à coup sûr, envoie-moi go sur Instagram.
I want to show you all my result photos, I guess progress photos from the Chloe Ting 2022 weight loss challenge because they're wild. Okay, so here's the front view, that's before, and then that's after. And then here's the side view, this is crazy, just like look at my chin, okay? Boom, it is incredible. Like if you're thinking about it, just, you know, thinking about it, you should probably, you know, do it. Like do it now, like put it on your TV and start doing it now. Like have you done it yet? Because that's the before, there's the after. Like if you haven't done it yet, you should, you know, like look how much perkier my butt is, all right? That's all you need to see. Anyways, I'm gonna be doing her hourglass challenge now, so thank you, Chloe.
Here's the dark truth about self-improvement that nobody talks about. You may become the best version of yourself, but as soon as you learn about what you should be doing, for example, I should be reading, I should be working out, I should be getting up early, it creates this mental checklist that if we don't do everything on that list, you use it as ammunition that you then use against yourself. And that's because the truth is that self-improvement alone doesn't satisfy us. Self-improvement is only one part of the journey. The other half that is vital for growth is self-acceptance. Accepting where you are right now. Accepting every small and big win. Learning from our losses and enjoying the now.
Voltei a ganhar peso.
Vocês estavam me cobrando a pesagem aqui, mas eu tava evitando fazer isso.
Principalmente porque eu tava vendo algumas mudanças que eu não tava gostando muito.
E andei tendo muitos deslizes com a minha alimentação.
Mas nessa última semana, apesar de não ter me alimentado tão bem como eu deveria,
eu me exercitei todos os dias.
E eu acho que pela primeira vez eu estou levando a sério o meu treino de musculação.
Então eu achei que estava na hora da gente voltar a ter o acompanhamento aqui semanal das pesagens.
Começando pelas medidas, eu estou com 122 centímetros de busto.
101 centímetros de cintura.
Confesso que essa parte me chocou um pouco. Eu estou com 120 centímetros de abdômen.
129 centímetros de quadril.
38 centímetros de braço.
E 71 centímetros de coxa.
Já a nossa pesagem vai ser muito diferente, porque agora eu tenho uma balança de bioimpedância Fit Days.
E é uma balança que não mostra só quanto eu tô pesando.
Ela mostra toda a minha composição corporal.
Vou mostrar mais dela pra vocês no próximo vídeo e também mostrar todos os resultados da minha bioimpedância.
Fica aí que o vídeo sai já já.
You get him a membership for 30 days.
Let the intense 30 days begin.
Okay, I just finished my first workout with Joe. It was even harder than I expected. I knew it was going to be a lot coming into it, but that was intense. If I lift my shoulders like that, I can feel it in my shoulders. Legs like that, chest killing me.
Okay, so what was Louis' workout program? Now, when creating this, I needed to realize we only had 30 days, so I needed to build something that would pack on the most amount of muscle in the shortest amount of time. This is what I made, a 3-day-a-week full body split. A workout consists of bench press, squats, pull-ups, incline dumbbell press, rows, lateral raises, and pec flies. Louis did this workout Monday, Wednesday, Friday, which means his full body muscles are going to be torn and repaired 3 times a week. That's going to lead to fast gains.
This man is overweight and he knows it, so he decided to change and he took a photo every single day to track his progress, and as you're about to see, he went all in. At first we can see some large breasts and a few rolls, but every day he checks himself into the gym and does not let go until his chest starts getting tighter and leaner and the rolls start to disappear as well. And his arms start getting really toned, but this is only the beginning. He keeps going until his body starts looking a little odd. I mean, don't get me wrong, he's lost a lot of fat, but he's also built quite a lot of muscle, but he's not satisfied yet. So he stays on his grind both in the gym and in the kitchen with a strict diet, and after a while there's still some fat, but his abs are now poking through the skin, and here's a side-by-side comparison to show you just how much he's changed. He's awesome, and if you'd like to go through a similar transformation, subscribe. This man is in jail, but today his wife came for a visit, and she made a huge mistake. Look at what the man does. He grabs hold of her hair and unties the knot in the back. The wife's emotional from seeing her man in jail, but it's not gonna last very long, because look at what he does with her hairband. He tied it to one of the poles in the cell door, and now look, he pulls on it using all of his strength, and the craziest thing is, the pole now literally bends to his will, and he's free to go. Beautiful.
I'm lost in the way you move, the way you feel.
Phénomène Zramdani. Depuis quelque temps maintenant, le Fit Game a les yeux rivés sur ce jeune de 19 ans, qui a déjà un physique exceptionnel. La plupart des gens connaissent Zram sur TikTok et pour sa présence dans de nombreuses vidéos d'influenceurs muscu. Que ce soit sur TikTok ou YouTube, sa présence dans les vidéos apporte une audience supplémentaire aux personnes qui l'invitent, et pour cause. Que ce soit tant sur son niveau physique ou sur ses perfs, Zram est impressionnant. Le jeune homme n'a jamais caché son ambition de faire des compétitions, mais il a toujours été plus frileux sur sa transparence vis-à-vis des produits dopants. Ses vidéos de motivation et de transformation ont suscité énormément de doutes et de réactions sur les réseaux sociaux. Depuis peu, Zram s'est lancé dans une grosse sèche, le but étant de monter sur scène. Et pour ce faire, il a décidé de prendre comme préparateur physique Essan NFC, qui est d'ailleurs le coach de beaucoup d'athlètes talentueux comme Stéphane Matala, un des gros espoirs français, à qui je souhaite énormément de réussite pour ses futures compétitions. La sèche de Zram avance et son physique aussi, et il est rare d'avoir une telle masse à son âge. Son physique et sa précocité dans ce sport me fait beaucoup penser à Lorenzo Baker, qui était lui aussi un énorme espoir du bodybuilding français. Il avait une génétique exceptionnelle, mais malheureusement il n'a jamais réussi à avoir un gros palmarès dans ce sport. La principale raison était son manque de régularité, chose que Zram n'a pas. Quoi qu'il en soit, Zram semble déterminé, et il veut se lancer dans la nouvelle catégorie reine du bodybuilding, le classique physique. Il a la génétique, la discipline, l'envie de réussir. Maintenant, il lui faut du courage et de la patience pour réussir, car c'est ce qui a manqué à beaucoup de bodybuilders français. Je pense notamment à Jojo Rush, qui était un athlète exceptionnel mais dont on n'entend plus parler actuellement. Et le bodybuilding français peut avoir beaucoup d'espoir en Zram, car il est très rare d'avoir un tel physique à 19 ans. N'oublie pas de liker cette vidéo, de t'abonner, c'est super important.
Day 30 of my transformation journey, and here's the results. But wait, before I reveal it, let's see a quick recap what I have done for the past 29 days. My workout primarily involves weight training and also cardio. I was doing this 3-day workout split, which is involving push day, which focusing on chest, shoulder and triceps, and then pull day focusing on back muscles and also biceps, and on leg day obviously focusing on your quadriceps, hamstring and also calves. From day 4 onwards, I started including cardio into my routine. I also did some bodyweight exercises because some of the days the gym were closed. From day 18 till day 29 was a disaster. If you were following my journey from the beginning, you would have known what has happened. I still squeezed in at least like 3 to 4 workout sessions and managed to do 2 cardio sessions. As for food, I controlled my portion and I tried my level best to follow a balanced diet and make sure I eat high amount of protein and also vegetables and also avoid oily foods. There were also days that I let myself loose and I also enjoyed eating out. Basically, that's it guys. Now it's time to see the results. On day 1, I weighed at 95.8 kg. Now I weigh at 91.4 kg. That means I lost 4.4 kg guys. And here's the pictures for day 1 and also day 30. Feel free to pause the video whenever you need to. And here's some side-by-side comparison. So do let me know what do you guys think about this transformation. And if you are new to my page, feel free to follow me to be part of the journey.